and then influencing it. The concept is that with an understanding of an individual's mind, keywords transmitted in music or white noise will force that person to obey. The FBI examined the system to use against David Koresh at Waco in Texas.
Los Alamos Labs in New Mexico is the clear leader in developing non-lethal weapons, such as laser lights that blind, sound waves that make large groups of people sick, microwaves that can burn people from a distance. These weapons are touted as being more humane, but in fact they disable a large group of people at one time, enabling a small group to go in and quickly and quietly kill them. John Alexander is the leader in the development of these weapons for Los Alamos. Several thousand U.S. troops are training in the U.S. this summer and fall, and if we look around us, we can see plenty of the signs and symptoms of a global takeover under the auspices of the United Nations taking place right here in our country. These trucks are Soviet trucks imported from eastern Germany, parked at a private facility in the DeSoto National Forest in Sodier, Mississippi, just outside Gulfport off Highway 59. A sign on the facility says Airmar. Airmar is privately owned, but the signs on fences around the facility say this is a U.S. Customs facility. Several acres of federal forest land was bulldozed to create this customs facility solely for Airmar. Airmar tells us these trucks are going to be refurbished, refitted, and repainted to be delivered to third world countries for use as vegetable and food trucks. However, these trucks began appearing in late February, and by July, none of these trucks had been refurbished. Notice that these trucks are fully loaded. Look closely at the equipment that includes equipment to spray nerve gas, tires that are self-inflating to travel in up to 4 feet of water, and heavy radio and communications equipment. They have bills of lading on them that plainly show these trucks were shipped from Germany, UN, meaning they were shipped out of Germany and into the U.S. with the UN bill of lading on them. These few white trucks, not chemical trucks, which Airmar admitted were not refurbished, were brought in from California as samples. Airmar claimed it was just a coincidence that white was a popular color in hot third world countries. This privately owned facility is protected by the federal government. Notice that here too there is a high radio tower. No one knows for sure what this facility really is, but one thing is certain, it's not what we're being told it is. And there are 750 Soviet chemical trucks sitting in Mississippi whose sole use is to spray chemicals and nerve gas in chemical warfare operations. What are they doing in Mississippi? What are they doing on U.S. soil? And why are they under the protection of the U.S. government if they are privately owned? The equipment on these trucks has not been stripped off and they are not being refurbished. Instead, they plainly look as if they are ready to be used, perhaps on us. Is this part of bringing UN troops into the United States as peacekeepers? It could well be. In the past year, we have located UN troops training at Fort Polk, Louisiana, Fort Chaffee, Arkansas, Camp Atterbury, Indiana, Fort Carson, Colorado, Fort Richardson, Alaska, Fort Benning, Georgia, Fort McCoy, Wisconsin, Fort Dix, New Jersey, Fort Rucker, Alabama, and the School of the Americas in Georgia. And Soviet troops are coming to this country for joint training throughout the summer and fall. Senator Sam Nunn from Georgia was quoted as saying he was certain the American public would welcome the Soviet troops as peacekeeping forces in the United States. Not only have these Soviet trucks been found in Mississippi, people recently photographed these two clearly marked Soviet vehicles in Texas. This wall, recently built at a National Guard facility in Gulfport, Biloxi, Mississippi Airport, is being made to encompass the entire facility and has gun turret holes throughout, though the wall is claimed to be a sound barrier. As you travel along Highway 59 from Gulfport, near a NASA facility, you'll be stopped along this state highway by an armed federal guard who will give you a pass marked NASA and no firearms, no cameras, no stopping, and don't get out of your car. At the Gulfport-Biloxi Regional Airport, there are also several unusual planes and black helicopters next to a National Guard facility. This is the same facility that has the so-called sound barrier wall. Thank you. This train full of American-made tanks was one of seven such trains that passed through Indianapolis en route to Fort Lewis, Washington in June. We were told that this was the 3rd Armored Division returning from Europe. Yet Fort Lewis has such a severe housing shortage that many military families are actually living in tents. Yet this whole division is being sent there. Three other such trains passed through Indianapolis in early August, one heading to Fort Riley, Kansas, another to Alabama, and the third to Fort Lewis, Washington. Are these tanks part of Operation Garden Plot, to be used to round us up for the slave labor camps, along with the black helicopters and federal law enforcement that look like active duty military stationed in our roadways as they were in Waco? Welcome to the New World Order. Expect no mercy.